stage 15 of the Tour de France, no one attacked GC-wise. People got shelled off the back. Adam Yates did one solo attack with about 5 kilometers to go. And that was it. It was a sprint finish, 600 meters to go. People started lighting it up. So why have mountain stages got to the point where they're basically like sprints? No one can attack from far out, especially at the Tour. And this has started in 2011, 2012, when Ineos, well, Sky back then, realized if you ride on the front at 6 watts per kilo, people can't, or more like just over 6 watts per kilo, burn off the riders, people cannot attack. And we're going to see the data behind this. So we're going to look at Sepp Kuss's data. Richie Port uploads to Strava, but no power, and Pogacar recently. He may have changed today, but I don't want to wait for it. I want to put up now the video, but he didn't upload with power. And also the difference is just in the last like 500 meters. So generally no need to worry about that. So the ride today, 5 hours at 297 normalized. So about 5 watts per kilo, a little less, like 4.9 for 5 hours. Very, very solid. He's put his weight up a little bit since the Dauphiné video. Average speed, very fast as well. I think it was Sepp Kuss's birthday today. We'll give him a bit of kudos. But we'll get into the ride and, you know, have a look at the general stage. So the stage is normalized. It was actually 303, a little bit higher because obviously they have the neutralized. But if we just look at the first, you know, part before the mountain, 252 normalized just here. So this is a Strava source extension. You can get it on Chrome. It's this thing up here, source for Strava. So if you want that, and all the data that goes with it, obviously download that. So 48 average is pretty quick, but 250 normalized is nothing too crazy for these boys. High zone 2, well, mid zone 2 probably for them. So the first climb was the Fourmentel. Couple power dropouts here, but nothing to be too concerned about. It doesn't change the average too much, but it was written at 5.6, which is a pretty solid tempo with 8%, 20k an hour, 19.5k an hour. Yeah, that's pretty fast. The last part was definitely steeper. It was 12%, and it was ridden, you know, slightly harder, 5.8 watts per kilo, but probably ridden similar watts per kilo wise, but just because it's steeper when you're sitting in, then obviously, you know, the watts per kilo are going to be higher when you get on a steeper section, even the guy on the front rides the same watts per kilo because you get less draft on the steeper parts. So anyway, then they descend, and then they do the beach. This is the full beach, but so the watts per kilo is only 5.5, but again, if we look at this, it's about 5.7. It's an 8% gradient, 18k an hour. But there were some steep sections on this point for sure, like 10%, 16k an hour here, 350 watts. So as we can see here, 5.7 watts per kilo. So again, you know, pretty rapid. Nothing, you know, monumental. But this last part here was again quite hard, about 6 watts per kilo for 3 minutes over the top. Then they descend into the valley here. So you know, again, just before the climb was 204 normalized. So actually a pretty easy descent generally. They weren't the front, you know, peloton. They knew they had the break where they wanted them. It's Pierre Rolland up the road with Michael Gurgel. He's just Harada. No, it was Gurgel and Pierre Rolland, and so they were up the road, so that was okay. But we'll look at the final climb, and we'll explain why people aren't attacking. So Sepp Kuss is singing most of the time, right? He's not doing a ton on the front. You can see this because the power is very choppy. Wout van Aert did most of the turns, and he did 5.9 watts per kilo. So that means the person on the front, you know, with a little bit of mass, is probably doing maybe 6.1, 6.2. So for you to attack, you have to do a burst above 6.2 watts per kilo. So let's say, you know, you do just 8 watts per kilo for like 20 seconds. Okay, you get the gap. It's not going to be huge. You're going to have a lot of lactate suddenly in your legs, and, you know, you need to dissipate that. So then if you're then riding at threshold, fair enough, you'll start to dissipate some, but you sort of then need to drop back a little bit below threshold and then ride to the end, unless obviously you attack towards the finish. The issue is, at this point in the race, I don't think many of them can ride over 6.2 watts per kilo, which is probably what the guys are doing on the front for Lotto and Al Jumbo. And I sort of guess that because here on the steeper section, when it's 9%, he was doing 6.1 Sepp Kuss. So maybe slightly more, maybe 6.3, but we'll say conservatively 6.2. When Adam Yates attacked, he got a gap. Then he can't ride at 6.2, because if he rides at 6.2, then he keeps the gap. Maybe he rides at 6.19, you know, just a little bit below, which is, I think, what he was doing. He gets brought back. Dumoulin goes slightly harder and brings him back. And that's it. So for you to attack and stay away, you need to be a lot, lot stronger than everyone else. You need the team who has control of the riders, which in this case was Lotto and Al Jumbo. If they wanted Roglic to attack and they knew he was stronger, then they'd burn up the riders. They'd get them to ride at 7 watts per kilo until they die and Roglic attack. Because then, if Roglic is stronger, everyone else would be massively in the red and he could go. So that's why no one can attack, because no one can put the burst in Even maybe just 8 watts per kilo. No, not crazy, not like a, you know, a massive surge, but just something to get away and then maintain over 6.2 watts per kilo, which is what they're doing on the front. And because that can't happen, then that is the reason why no one attacks. It's quite simple, really. And this climb again is useless because it's 7%. That sounds quite steep, but there's really fast sections, there's really steep sections. So you know, if you're sitting in, you're like, I might be suffering here, or you know, I'm feeling all right. But if I attack on this part here, like look how, like before the finish line, the average speed is 28K an hour. Sepp Kuss is doing like 5.5. That's like tempo for him. Like that is the reason why it's just so useless attacking, because you can't get away, because it's just so easy to sit in on the high speed sections on this climb. So you know, like I can't put time into Roglic, because if I attack, his teammates are going to bring me back. So that's it. It's done. It's pretty simple, really. If we look at the highest 20 minute of power of the day, that was the first 20 minutes was ridden at 6 watts per kilo, Sepp Kuss. So maybe 6.2, 6.3 on the front, which is yeah, obviously very strong, and that's what dropped Bernal and Quintana. But I mean, this is why people are getting dropped. This is why no one attacks. So yeah, you know, it's like you might be able to climb at 1600 VAM here, like 1530 VAM, whatever. But like you can't climb above it because the guy's just going to chase you down. So yeah, there we go. It's quite simple. It doesn't make it exciting races. Terreno has been a lot more exciting this week than the tour has. But it's the tour. I get it. People want to win. People don't want to mess around. So you know, you can understand why it's like ridden like this compared to maybe the Giro where there's less strong teams. But I think you know, in the future, the tour. I mean, it's the same with Ineos. Ineos have done it. Okay. The last couple of years have been more exciting for sure. 2018 was slightly better. 17 was dull. Okay, Froome did a couple attacks. 2019 was very exciting as well because Ineos didn't have a dominating team. This year again, we've got a team that dominates, and then they just set tempo on the climbs and no one can attack. But Jumbo Visma have gone to like a different degree. Like at least with Ineos, you used to get a Froome dog attack at like 2 or 3 kilometers go. People would start to go. Now you watch the whole mountain stage. It could be summed up with. The highlight package, if I was ASO tonight, would be Bernal Quintana get dropped to the bottom climb. Maybe he get to crash, show Dumoulin and what's his face, Wout van Aert on the front, and then show the last 600 meters. Genuinely no point watching. It was pointless. These were just warm ups. No one attacked. No one did nothing because they know the teams are too strong. So yeah, that's why no one attacks, because the teams are strong. And if you attack, you go into the red and blow up because you can't hold over 6.3 watts per kilo for this effort. It's quite simple, really. And it was quite annoying to be honest to watch, but anyway, is what it is. We're gonna get more exciting races, I hope. The tour's never normally the most exciting, in my opinion. It's always World to Giro, things like that, where there's less control, more people are really trying to make it, and that's where exciting races, Spring Classics is the same, less calculated, super, super exciting. So, anyway, cheers for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.